Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Blazor Carousel from Syncfusion. Using the Carousel component, you can display a series of images like a slideshow. It's a great fit for scrolling news headlines, articles on home pages, and image galleries. In this video, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Carousel to a Blazor app. To explore other features available in our Blazor Carousel, refer to the link in the card above. Now, let's add the Syncfusion Blazor Carousel to a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019. In this tutorial, I am going to create a new Blazor app, but before I do, I will make sure the latest version of the .NET Core SDK is installed in my machine. I should also have Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio 2019, or Visual Studio 2022 installed. With that confirmed, we can start building the app. Let me open Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly app and click Next. Then, I name my project Blazor Carousel Example and click Next. After that, I click the Create button with the default target framework selected to complete the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components to them, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. Now let's add the Blazor Carousel component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Navigation's NuGet package in my application. So, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I will search for Syncfusion Blazor Navigations in the Browse tab and install it into my project. Once the installation is complete, I navigate to the imports.razor file. Here, I will add the Syncfusion Blazor Navigations namespace to start using the Blazor Carousel in any of the components available under the Pages folder. Next, I open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method addSyncfusionBlazor within this main method. Here, by default, the ignore script isolation option is set to true to load the script reference externally. I should also register a valid license key in my application, so let me register a trial license key using the registerLicense method. I then need to define the CSS for the Blazor Carousel. I navigate to the index.html file to refer the Blazor CSS CDN link inside the head section. I add the script reference here, since JavaScript isolation is enabled by default for better loading performance in the application. Now everything is configured, so let me add the Blazor Carousel component. First, I need to open the index.razor component, where I will replace the default code by including a Blazor Carousel component within the division element. Now, I plan to display four images in the carousel component. So, first, let me define four carousel item tags inside the Blazor Carousel code. Then, I will define an image element within the figure element for these carousel items. You may be wondering why we use image and figure elements. The image element is used to embed the image, but the figure element is used to semantically organize the content of the image. Next, I set the source path for the images using the source attribute and add alternate names for the images. Along with this, I define a few CSS styles within this style section. Now, I will run this example. You can see in the output page, the images are arranged here like a typical slideshow. Notice that the images change automatically at a regular interval. Also, notice here that an indicator is shown to indicate the current page of the carousel and to allow users to move to a specific images. You can also manually move to next image using this next navigator and move to the previous image with the previous navigator. Suppose I want to show a caption for an image. I define a figure caption element and set an appropriate value to it. And I define a few CSS styles for this image caption within this style section. See the output page now. The caption is above the indicator of the image. Next, let's bind a data source to the Blazor Carousel component. To continue further, I remove the existing carousel items from the Blazor Carousel code and add the CSS class property to set class name for the carousel component. Then, I define the model class carousel data model with three fields, ID, title, and image name. I create a list called carousel data of type carousel data model and assign an array of objects with these fields. Now, I am going to iterate the objects, so let me add a for each statement here and add a few HTML elements inside the carousel item tag. I iterate the items from the carousel data list. As you know, I need to display the image, so I define the image element and set the source path for it using the source attribute. I set an alternate name for the image. Next, I add a header tag and assign the title field using the data variable. Then, I plan to set background for the indicator, so let me remove the existing styles and define background color attribute with appropriate color code. Looking at the carousel component now, it shows the image and title. If I want to display an image description, then I need to add one more field, called content, to the carousel data model class and assign values to it. To display the image content, I add a paragraph element and set the content using a data variable. Along with this, I change the height for the image element. You can see that the carousel component shows an image description below here. Let's recap what we have covered in this video. We saw how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019 and add a Syncfusion Blazor Carousel component to it. We discussed how to add images and captions to the component. We also saw how to bind the data source to the Blazor Carousel component. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.